सदाशिवसमारं शंकराचार्य मध्यमा अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरा श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ नक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। ब्रह्माणिधातिपुरो यदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्भदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणं हं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायान्तेन संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। समुदाय उभयहेतु के अपि तदप्राप्ति ही, दैट इज द लास्ट सूत्र वी सॉ। दी बौद्ध पक्ष इज बीइंग रिफ्यूटेड इन दी फोर बौद्ध पक्षास। टू ऑफ देम कंसिडर दैट देर इज अ बाह्य प्रपंच फॉर विच दी परमाणुज आर हेतु, एंड दी अदर टू कंसिडर दैट दी स्कंदास विच आर इन दी अंतकरण और दी in the within, they are the hetus for the prapancha outside. the bahya samudaya which is seen as prapancha, for that either the paramanu or the skanda is the hetu. So the sutra said that samudaya ubhayetu ke api taraprapti, samudaya aprapti hi, whether the paramanus outside are the hetus or skandas within are the hetus, ubhay hetu ke api samudaya praptihi, samudaya is not possible, said the sutra. The vritti says phalam purvavat, samudaya the samanvaya siddhi and asiddhi as per the siddhanti and purvapakshi. However, what we should notice is that this samanvaya that the Shruti is showing or not showing as per the Purvapakshis, they have to be Astikas. So here, although Phalam Purvat has been mentioned, Baudhas have nothing to do with the Shastra or the Shruti. So samanvaya which is saying that the Brahma is Jagat Karana, that is being opposed. Meaning, whether the Shruti's Tatparya is in Brahma or something else is irrelevant to the Baudha, as far as Shruti Tatparya is the focus. But what is the Jagat Karana, whether Shruti says it or not, is not the focus area. But Jagat Karana is Brahma, and that there is something called as Brahma, that itself is being argued by the Purvapakshi, because Baudhas do not consider Shruti as Pramana, they are Nastikas. So what we should understand Phalam Purvavat is that the Purvapakshi says that Brahma cannot be Jagat Karana, whereas Siddhanti says that Brahma is definitely Jagat Karana. For what reason? There is no Shruti needed as basis to refute the पूर्वपक्षि, तर्क इज सफिशियंट इनफ। सो चत्वारा खलु बुद्ध मुनेः विनेयाः, विनेयाः मीन्स शिष्याः। सो देर आर फोर शिष्यास दैट बुद्ध हैड, वैभाषिक सौत्रांतिक विज्ञानवादी सर्वशून्यवाद्याख्याः। सो दोज हू फॉलो बौद्ध दर्शन, they are categorized into four: vaibhashika, sautrantika, vijnanavadi and sarvashunyavadi, shunyavadis. So tatra adau vaibhashika sautrantika yoho bahya astitva avisheshat, the vaibhashika and the sautrantika are the first two who do not have a difference in the darshana as far as the prapancha being outside is concerned. So they say that prapancha is outside, therefore avisheshat, bahya astitva. कस्य प्रपंचस्य सो घटपटादि प्रपंच इज देयर आउटसाइड व्हाट इट्स नेचर इज ऑल दैट इज आर्ग्यूएबल मीनिंग इज डिबेटेबल बिटवीन देम बट देन whether or not there is a prapancha outside, for that they say it is there. So it is not that prapancha is completely non-existent. As per the other two vijnanavadis and sarvashunyavadis. Akhyas, so this is bhauri, akhya meaning those who are called so. So Vaibhashika, Sautrantika, vijnanavadi and sarvashunyavadi is the akhya for which vineya, shishyas of Buddha Muni are this entire samasa, Bhauri samasa. So tatra adau vaibhashika sautrantikayoho, the first two having no difference between the prapancha being bahya, astitva of the prapancha bahya, tanmatam ekikrutya tatkim pramanamulam bhrantimulam vaiti sandehe, sandehe prakte. So when you combine these two pakshas, now you have to analyze what is their viewpoint, their mata has been combined. Ekikrutya, that mata, whether it is having pramana as its basis or it is just an imagination, some delusion. Bhranti is the basis. Bhranti mulam vaiti sandeha, which is what the second pada is all about, to prove that the Purvapakshi's darshana is bhranti mula, not pramana mula. So when such a doubt has come up, पृथिव्यादीनि चत्वारि भूतानि भौतिकानि विषयेन्द्रियाणि च परमाणु पुञ्ज स्वरूपाणि सेज दि पूर्वपक्षी दि बौद्धास वैभाषिक एंड सौत्रांतिक बौद्धास से दैट दि दि बाह्य प्रपंच इज मेड अप ऑफ परमाणुस And what is the basis basically? If you look at it, Paramanus are not visible. But then do you agree with the Panchamahabhutas? Ask the Purvapakshi to the Siddhanti. Siddhanti says yes. Okay, we do not agree with Akasha, but other four which you agree with, among those five, we agree with the four. So Prithiviyadini Chattvari, except for Akasha, from the other side, from the grossest Prithvi to the subtlest Vayu. So Prithvi, Jala, Vanni and Vayu, these are the four Bhutas, Chattvari Bhutani, and then elementals, these are the elements and then elementals which are created out of these by summing them up together in whatever proportion, Bhautikani, Vishayindriyani cha. So Bhautikas are what elementals, they are Vishayas as well as Indriyas, Indriyas to cognize those very Vishayas which are both the products of the Chattvari Bhutas. So Bhautikani Vishayendriyani cha Paramanu Punja Swarupani. So they are what? Punja is a heap, a grouping. So Paramanu Punja Swarupani. So Paramanu Naam Punjaha Swarupam Yesham. Tani Paramanu Punja Swarupani. What are those? They are all these विषयेन्द्रियाणि भौतिकानि च सो भूतानि भौतिकानि सो चत्वारि भूतानि भौतिकानि विषयेन्द्रियाणि च परमाणु पुञ्ज स्वरूपाणि सो फ्रॉम दी फोर महाभूतास भौतिकास हैव कम अप एंड विषयेन्द्रियास हैव कम अप एंड व्हाट आर दीज प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ दे देमसेल्व्स आर द प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ परमाणुस देयरफॉर द एटम्स हैव क्रिएटेड ऑल ऑफ दीज व्हिच आर Finally seen as the grossified prapancha with the vishayas and the indriyas cognizing them, including the shariras also. Now tatra bahyaha prithivyadi samudaya paramanu hetuka eva. So bahya prithivyadi samudaya, the outer world is what is being analyzed. We are not worried about the inner world right now, meaning the antakkarana ityadi is not being questioned. Antakkarana indriyas, when we talk about jagat generally, it is a prapancha outside. In fact the sharira is also missed out. Whether the sharira is included or not, people do not think. whether Sharira is part of Jagat or not. Really, Sharira is part of the Jagat. But then not everyone can understand this when the word Jagat is mentioned. Because as soon as you say Jagat, it is the objectifiable word. And what is objectifiable to you is objectifiable to others also. With this thinking, we miss that the others are also objectifiable by us and we are also objectifiable by others. Therefore, the we meaning the Sharira. So, the Sharira being objectifiable is also part of the Jagat, but it doesn't flash in the mind when we say Jagat. So, we think of Ghatapadadi Prapancha, not the sentient beings Sharira, meaning the Sharira of the sentient beings. Nonetheless, even if you consider only the Ghatapatadi Prapancha, the insentient Prapancha, there Tatra Bhaiha Prithivyadi Samudayaha, the collection of Prithivityadi, all of that is what? Paramanu Hetuka, meaning Paramanus are the Hetu for these Bhauri Kapratya. Paramanu Hetuka Eva, they are born out of Paramanus. Now, Adhyatmiko Rupadi Samudayaha, what about this Adhyatmika Rupadi Samudayaha? What is within the Sharira? Being within the Sharira, you see outside, cognize, and whatever is within the Sharira, what about that? Adhyatmika Rupadi Samudayaha, Rupa Vijnana Vedana Sanya Samskara Lakshana Panchaka Skanda Hetukaha. And they say that whatever is the Adhyatmika Prapancha, meaning Rupadi Samudaya, what you cognize in your Antakkarana, all of that is what your emotional mind, what does it see? Basically, all the colouring that you have in the mind, Ranja Rage, all the Ragadvesha, what we say is Ragadvesha Krita, or even without the Ragadvesha, even if you are neutral and you are just having Jnana of the Bahya Prapancha, still within you see something. What you see within and what you see outside, there may be disconnect. That's why we have Bhranti also. So all of that, whether it is Pramana, Mulaka, meaning the Jnana which is there within, whether it has Pramana, it is through the Pramana, or which is invalid, Bhranti, proven invalid later, Swapna Prapancha also. So all of that is what? The Rupadi Samudayaha is Rupa, it's a group of Rupa Ityadi. That is a combination of five Skandhas. So these are called as Skandhas. Skandhas are the Hetu for them. What are the Skandhas? Rupa is one Skandha, Vijnana is another, Vedana is third, Sanya is fourth, and Samskara is fifth. Therefore, Rupa, Vijnana, Vedana, Sanya, Samskara, Lakshana, Panchaka. Panchaka is five. So characterized by Panchaka, the Pentad characterized by Rupa, Vijnana, Vedana, Sanya and Samskara. We will not look at these individual as to what they are. Those who are interested can see this. This is also covered in Dakshinamurti Stotra Tika Vyakhya called Manasollasa. So Bhagavan Sureshwaracharya covers a lot of details as to what these Skandhas are. He mentions, meaning he also covers them while refuting them. So first you have to know what these are, but these are not really the focus. We don't want to study Bauddha Darshana in depth. This is sufficient information as to Rupa, Vijnana, Vedana. So whatever general understanding of the term is there, that is sufficient, need not be translated also. Sanya and Samskara. So these are the Lakshana for the Panchaka, the five, and those are the Skandhas. Those Skandhas, meaning these five grouped together, those kind of five Skandhas grouped together are the Hetu for the Adhyatmika Prapancha. Iti Tanmatam Pramanikam iti Purvah Pakshaha. So categorizing this as Bahya Prapancha and the Adhyatmika Prapancha, the Vaibhashika and Sautrantika Bauddhas say that Paramanus are the Hetu for the outer world, and for the inner world, Skandhas are the Hetus. We detail these in our Granthas, and therefore there is Pramana for this. It is not that we have some Bhranti. We have analyzed this very well. इति तन्मतम प्रामाणिकम इति पूर्वपक्ष. सो दि वैभाषिक एंड सौत्रांतिक मत इज डेफिनेटली वैलिड सेज दि पूर्वपक्ष. सिद्धांतस्तु उभयहेतुके समुदाये वेदर यू से परमाणु हेतु का बाह्य समुदाय और स्कंध हेतु का आध्यात्मिक समुदाय बेसिकली दिस इज बोथ सो च इज देयर. सो उभय हेतु के वेदर यू कंसिडर वन और इन वन ऑफ द टू और बोथ ऑफ देम द वे यू डिस्क्राइब इन ईदर के समुदाय इज नॉट पॉसिबल. द प्रपंच समुदाय इज अप्राप्त देर अप्राप्ति ऑफ दैट समुदाय. सो उभय हेतु के अपि समुदाय मीनिंग परमाणु हेतु के बाह्य समुदाय एंड स्कंद हेतु के आध्यात्मिक समुदाय च दी बाह्य समुदाय दी दी प्रपंच ग्रुप्ड देयर आउटसाइड बीइंग क्रिएटेड फ्रॉम परमाणुस एंड दी दी इनर समुदाय आध्यात्मिक समुदाय all the cognitions group together within forming the adhyatmika prapancha there skanda are the hetus even then the samudaya is not possible taraprapti means tasya samudaya se aprapti hi samudaya is not possible. Samudaya is aggregates the aggregates are not possible because you are talking about these individual skandas and suddenly you jump to the aggregates. So there is a hetu hetu mat bhava which has to be established first. And that hetu hetu mat bhava can be between individual something that you can prove. So you can say that okay, samskara is there. If at all you can prove, let's say you know rupa is rupa skanda. There is some skanda ka skanda which is some skanda which is hetu for rupa. Meaning the rupa hetu for the adhyatmika rupa that you see for that rupa skanda is a hetu. So all that you talk about that skanda. Individual you can talk about but you cannot group them together as an aggregate. Samudaya will not be possible. How so? Because for samudaya to take place even karya karana bhava hetu hetu mat bhava that itself is being refuted on the larger scale. How will these come together in a certain proportion and form an aggregate whether it is outside or within? How will something lead to the other grouping? How will they come together? Finally, some parts have to come together to form a whole. That is the karya. So when you say samudaya aprapti hi, taraprapti, samudaya aprapti, what is meant is that parts coming together and becoming an aggregation, a whole, a grouping is not possible. Meaning karya is not possible. You may have identified individual karana and karya karana bhava there with individuals because there is some similarity in your analysis and you say that this is the hetu for this hetu mat, this is the karana for this karya, but that karya is a sum of parts. That sum of parts, even if you identified these parts and then you say that okay these parts have come together, that coming together to make the karya is not possible. Similar reasoning is applied as it is applied to pradhana being karana. Parts cannot come together because chetana has to be there. All these are jada, whether paramanus of tarkikas or pradhana of sankhyas, both are jada. So jadatva is the hetu for samudaya prapti, taraprapti, samudaya prapti. Here also your rupa vijnana vedana sanya samskara or paramanus outside, for both of these bahya and adhyatmika samudaya there has to be chetana needed. That chetana is not acceptable to you. In the case of tarkikas and sankhyas at least chetana is there. We had to struggle to say that if at all you say this chetana is contributing then you will have compromised your siddhanta where you say independent pradhana or independent atoms are jagat karana. However, in the case of the Bauddhas, there is no chetana in all the four pakshas, whether it is Vaibhashika, Sautrantika, Vijnanavadi or Sarvashunyavadi, there is no chetana at all. Two of them agree with Paramanus, the other two do not agree with Paramanus also, they say that there is nothing outside. So, in that case, where is this chetana at all? Whether or not Adhara or not an Adhara or whether a Bhokta or a contributor or not, all that discussion is irrelevant to Bauddhas because they do not have anything called as Chetana. Therefore, this Samudaya will not be possible. They will not come together on their own. Whether this Kandas grouping together into Samudaya or Parmanus grouping together into Samudayas outside, neither of this is possible. Even if you accept the Hetus, even if you accept that there are these individual Hetus, they by themselves cannot become Hetu for the entire Karya. You have identified something called as Hetu, but that Hetu is not really a Hetu. There is a Bhranti of that Hetu for the Karya, because Samudaya is a Karya. So Siddhantastu Ubhay Hetu ke api Samudaya, Paramanu Hetu ke Bhaya Samudaya, Skanda Hetu ke Adhyatmika Samudaya cha Tarap Prapti Tasya Samudayasya Aprapti Hi Shashti Tat Purusha Samasa, and Tat there stands for Samudaya. Karya basically. Chetananam Paramanunam Skandanam cha Swatas Samudaya Ayoga. So Kutaha can be read here to make sense of the connection there. So why do you say there is a Samudaya Aprapti in either case or in with both? Bhaya Prapancha and Bhaya Samudaya and Adhyatmika Samudaya Aprapti, why do you say so? So the Siddhanti says Achetananam Paramanunam Skandanam cha. Skandas and Paramanus, Paramanus which are cause for the world outside as per your darshana, they are Achetana. And Skandas within for the Adhyatmika Prapancha, they are also Achetana. So Tesham Achetananam cha Swatas Samudaya Ayogat. They cannot come together to form a Karya on their own. And there is nothing else. In the case of Astika Darshanas, there is Chetana, Purusha, Ishvara outside, but does not get involved directly into creation. Therefore, we just had to show Virodha with their Darshana if at all they agree with the Anya being a participant. They would have compromised their own Darshanas. But in your case, your compromise is at this level itself. If you accept a Chetana, whether a contributor or not, just accept the Chetana, that itself will make your Darshana compromise. So, Anyasya cha Sthirasya Chetanasya Samudaya Kartuhu Anabhyupagamat Teshu Teshu Bauddha Granteshu Darshaneshu. So, in your own Darshanas, there is Darshana Granthas, there is no Chetana accepted. Therefore, that Chetana who is Thira, who should be outside the Skandas and Paramanus, who is other than the Skandas and Paramanus, and that who is Thira. Because for something to come together and to put together, that entity who is putting the others together and creating a change should himself be changeless. You cannot have one which is undergoing change create the other change. Meaning, the changes cannot cause change in the others while undergoing change oneself. Actually, finally, it will turn out to be only Sakshi who is Thira, who is a witness to all this. Anyway, that's the Siddhanta, but here, Sthirasya Chetanasya Samudaya Kartuhu, who can be Samudaya Karta, Tasya Samudaya Kartuhu, Anabhyupagamat, due to non-acceptance. Where in your Shastras, in your Darshanas, not Shastra, in your Darshana. Ataha Tanmatam Bhranti Mulam iti Siddham. Therefore, the Vaibhashika and Sautrantika Matha, at least the two Pakshas of the Bauddhas, out of four are Bhranti Mula. That is established. Now, the next Sutra is considering the other Paksha, the same Paksha, but there is an argument there, meaning Bauddhas. Although we have categorized, we need not categorize also. They can be considered as all four together and still having an argument with the Siddhanti. So this Samudaya Karta is absent is being said because Chetana, Purusha, Ishvara, that kind of an entity is not accepted. Brahma, Parabrahma or Brahma, Atma, Ityadi words, whatever words we use, is not accepted in the Bauddha Grantha. So here the next sutra is introduced by the Vritti saying nanu samhantuhu chetanasya abhavyapi sanghata upapadyate iti ashankya pariharati. There should be space after ashankya. So pariharati, ashankya pariharati, raising a doubt, the sutrakara gives a solution to this. As to Purvapakshi saying nanu samhantuhu chetanasya, the samhanta, the one who is putting the samudaya together, that kind of a chetana is not accepted in our grantha, we agree. So chetanasya abhavyapi, even if we do not accept, even then that chetana not being there also, sangata upapadyate, still sangata is possible. The samudaya, samudaya and sangata are interchangeable, they are grouping. Sangata is a grouping, you group together to form a karya. So sangata upapadyate iti ashankya pariharati, it is possible, it is still tenable, logical to have a sangata without the chetana samudaya karta. How so? So there the sutrakara refutes that, takes how so and refutes. Itare itara pratyatvaditi chennotpatti matra nimittatvat, itare itara pratyatvaditi chennotpatti matra nimittatvat. So itare itara pratyatvat iti chet, says the Purvapakshi. Na is the siddhanta, na. Why? Utpatti matra nimittatvat, that is the last hetu, single pada. So itare itara pratyatvad iti chet na utpatti matra nimittatvat. So the Purvapakshi says without the chetana also there can be sanghata possible, samudaya possible. Why? Itare itara pratyatvat. Pratyaya here is in the sense of karana. So itare itara karanatvat ityartha. So itare itara karana, mutually they are creators of each other, meaning mutually, in the sense mutually it need not mean as to mutual dependency dosha, anyonya ashraya dosha, but like the seed and the tree. So one seed is karana for the tree and that tree is the karana for the next seed and that next seed is the karana for the next tree. So there is no anyonya ashraya dosha, there is no mutual dependency, but then there can be a series of itare itara karanatvam. So itare itara pratyatva, that is what the Purvapakshi means there. Iti chet, and thereby sangata is possible, as to the series is a sangata. You will have one cause for the other and then they'll work with each other in this manner. Because one leads to the other leads to the next one. Meaning the, you take, let's say, avidya. So, avidya, samskara, ityadi. We also talk about the triad. We say avidya will lead to karma and then karma will lead to samskara. And then the triad continues. So, avidya, karma, samskara, or avidya, the triad is avidya, avidya leads to, there is a raga and then there is karma. So avidya, raga, karma, ityadi, we talk about such things. So similarly, why can't there be such dependency among the skandhas also, skandhakaryas also, meaning skandhas lead to lot of things. And then, so Rupa, for example, see, just to give some, although I said I will not give translations for this, but a basic translation you can consider for understanding as to Rupa. So Rupa is what? So Rupa is basically form. Generally Rupa means color, but then color or form also. So here it means the bodily form. The bodily form, Sharira, Ityadi, form that you see, they are all the Rupa, categorized as Rupa. Vijnana is known. What is Vijnana? So Vijnana in the case of Bauddha, when we say Kshanika Vijnana Vadi, there we mean the वृत्ति, दी वृत्ति विच इट सेल्फ अपियर्स एज कॉन्शियस एंड देयर फोर दे मिसकॉन्स टू कॉन्शियसनेस आत्मा, ऑल्दो दे डोंट हैव एनीथिंग कॉल्ड एज आत्मा द वे वी हैव, बट दे ऑल्सो हैव द वर्ड आत्मा, एज इन दैट आत्मा इज द चेतना विच इज विज्ञान, एंड वॉट इज दैट, दैट इज क्षणिका. सो इट इज बेसिकली वृत्ति इन द सिद्धांत, एंड दे कंसिडर दिस वृत्ति, whether you, they call it as consciousness or the thought faculty itself, that itself is vijnana. That itself is vijnana. So vijnana is the conscious vritti, which actually cannot be conscious. There is a contradiction in terms there, but that is what they have concluded. So they say vijnana is that conscious vritti. That itself is consciousness. There is nothing called as consciousness separate from the vritti. So it comes up and goes in Kshanika Vijnana. So we take the Kshanika Vijnana to understand what this Vijnana word means for all Bauddhas. So Vijnana means consciousness, which is not the Atma consciousness, the way the Chaitanya Swarupa of the Atma, which never goes, but they say that this consciousness is the Ghata Jnana, Pata Jnana, Ityadi coming up. Therefore, the entire set of vrittis are categorized as Vijnana, where the there is abhasa of the jiva being conscious also. Then sanya is perception, the cognition itself is called as sanya there. And samskara is the aggregate of these formations, so which basically what we call as leaves a samskara. So that kind of a meaning samskara has. So with this with these basic basic understanding of what these skandhas are, we can see at the next sutra, itaretara pratyatva. The word itaretara pratyatva, itaretara karanatva. So the itaretara karana, as to even if you consider the siddhanti says, even if you consider that the itaretara karana, one leads to the other, just like a pravaha, avidya leads to the doshas, avidya itself is a dosha and it leads to other doshas like kama, so raga or kama. So avidya, raga and karma, what the siddhanti talks about there also, what avidya is karana for kama, kama is karana for karma, karma leads to samskara, samskara does not let the avidya go, avidya continues, and in the next janma that avidya is karana for another set of ragas or kama, and those other set of kamas are going to lead to other set of karmas, which will lead to other set of samskaras, and so on. So there is always a cyclical continuation with a mutual triggering of the other. So it's a what we call as a vicious circle. So this also, this sanghata also, here these sanghatas also, what we have here, rupa adi samudaya, is a product of rupa vijnana vedana sanya and samskara. So these also can have one leading to the other and thereby form the karya. So that kind of an argument is made, which is refuted in the sutra by saying iti chet na, that is not so. Why? Utpatti matra nimittatvat, there can be no combination of those. Why? Because utpatti matra nimitta, they only lead to something being formed. They cannot help the karya to be formed because karya is a samudaya, and this samudaya, karya samudaya cannot be there as to all of these coming together and forming samudaya, which is karya. Why? Because one will lead to trigger to the other, meaning utpatti of the other. Now one leading to the utpatti of the other, what happens to the first one? It is no longer there to mix up, or later it does not contribute to anything else. After the utpatti has taken place, then this summing up or aggregation of those cannot be formed by this hetu. It may at most trigger and form the next, whatever is that next. So the first can form the next, utpatti of the next, but then there won't be any combination of anything possible further than that. So that much, if at all we have to agree with, we'll agree that the utpatti is possible. उत्पत्ति मात्र. सो दी वॉट यू कॉल एज दी हेतु, इतरेतर हेतु, हेतु विल बी वॉट, इतरेतर प्रत्यय इज इतरेतर कारण, इतरेतर हेतु. म्यूचुअली हेतुज फॉर ईच अदर, दे आर हेतुज, इफ एट ऑल दे आर हेतुज ओनली फॉर दी उत्पत्ति ऑफ दी अदर, नॉट दी समुदाय विद दी अदर, समुदाय ऑफ दी अदर्स ऑल्सो. देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ देम समिंग अप. सो दैट इज दी, दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ उत्पत्ति मात्र निमित्तत्वात् एज द हेतु फॉर रिफ्यूटेशन ऑफ समुदाय फॉर्मेशन एंड देयर बाय देयर बीइंग हेतु फॉर समुदाय. सो देर आर लॉट ऑफ दीज रिजल्टेंट्स विच आर देर, दे आर सो वेदर इट इज इन दी बाह्य प्रपंच और इन दी अंतः प्रपंच इवन इफ यू टॉक अबाउट वन द अदर इज रिफ्यूटेड. सो दी वृत्ति सेज अविद्या संस्कार विज्ञानम इत्येवं जातीयकानां अविद्यादीनां इतरेतर प्रत्ययत्वात्. सो दी पूर्वपक्षी बौद्ध सेज ऑल दीज अविद्या संस्कार विज्ञानम ऑल दीज आर देर एवं जातीय एंड देर आर मेनी ऑफ दी सेम कैटेगरी. देर आर ब्रॉड कैटेगरीज ऑफ विच आर कवर्ड इन स्कंदा बट दे लीड टू अ लॉट ऑफ एंड कार्यास. सो अविद्या संस्कार विज्ञानम इति एवं जातीय दे कीप ऑन लीडिंग टू सेवरल ग्रुप्स एंड देर फोर तज्जाति एवं जातीय देर आर लॉर्ड ऑफ दीज विच आर कॉल्ड अविद्यादि. अविद्यादीना इतरेतर प्रत्ययत्वा सिंस इतरेतर प्रत्ययत्व इज इतरेतर कारणत्व. सो इतरेतर कारणत्वा बिकॉज दे आर म्यूचुअली द कॉज फॉर ईच अदर इन अ सीरीज. हाउ घटी यंत्रवत लाइक यू नो लाइक द क्लॉक वन लीड्स टू द अदर एंड सो ऑन लाइक क्लॉक वर्क प्रिसीजन समथिंग गोज ऑन. सो सिमिलर इज दी इज अवर यू नो अवर प्रपंचना इज लाइक दैट इज दी बौद्ध पक्ष. सो घट यंत्रवत लाइक दी क्लॉक गोज अराउंड विथ पार्ट्स ट्रिगरिंग दी अदर. घट यंत्रवत अनिशम आवर्तमानेषु अविद्यादिषु अर्थादाक्षिप्त संगात उपपद्यते इति चेत् न. So one triggers the other triggers something else and so on. Is, you know, the wheel is set in motion and just like the small wheels of the clock or a watch, if you've seen, you know, mechanical clocks of the earlier era, watches or clocks. So these wheels set the others into motion. You know, just like all these gears come together and then they make a huge thing happen. Like the even you know, the motor vehicles move, something like that. So similarly this prapanchanam is like that, one triggers the other triggers the third and so on. So if that kind of a prapanchana is possible, then why can't our skandhas and paramanus be hetus? So there the Purvapakshi is saying avidyadishu arthad akshiptaha. So anisham continuously what anisham avartamaneshu avidyadishu continuously is avidyadi. There is a flow, there is a series. So avidyadishu arthad akshiptah sangata. So sangata of all these is possible definitely, one triggering the other and there is a series and therefore there is a sangata. Sangata can be inferred by that arthad akshiptah sangata upapadyate iti chet. It is tenable to logically infer, it is tenable that we can infer that in this avidyadi, all these many prapanchanam of the adhyatmika ityadi prapancha, the prapanchanam of these expanse of the adhyatmika prapancha itself and similarly extending it to the parmanu outside, bahya prapancha also, this prapanchanam is definitely possible as samavaya, as this samavaya is possible, samudaya is possible. As to what you say samudaya aprapti, that is not right, says the Purvapakshi to Siddhanti. Why? Because ghati yantravad anisham avartamanishu, these are continuous series of avidyadi. So avidyadishu artha akshipta sangata, दिस संगात विच कैन बी इन्फर्ड इज टेनेबल उपपद्यते इति चेत न वाई उत्पत्ति मात्र निमित्तत्वा सेज सिद्धांती इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल दैट समुदाय इज पॉसिबल इवन इफ वन इज म्यूचुअली ट्रिगरिंग द अदर इवन देन एज अ सीरीज अविद्यादीनां इतरेतर कारणत्वे अपि उत्पत्ति मात्र निमित्तत्वा सो इफ यू से अविद्यादि आर कारण अविद्या संस्कार विज्ञान दीज आर ऑल कारण फॉर ईच अदर इन अ सीरीज इतरेतर कारणत्वे इज एज अ सीरीज ऑल्सो अपि उत्पत्ति मात्र निमित्तत्वा दे विल जस्ट मेक द उत्पत्ति ऑफ द अदर एंड देयरफॉर व्हाट तव अभिमतः हेत्वादिना कारण समुदायादिनश्च कार्योत्पादो न संभवती सो दैट समुदाय विच इज कार्य दैट विल नॉट बी पॉसिबल बिकॉज तव अभिमत इन युअर बौद्ध मत वॉट इज एक्सेप्टेड सच काइंड ऑफ अ हेतु विल बी लैकिंग सो हेतु अधीन कारण समुदाय अधीनश्च कार्योत्पादो न संभवति कार्योत्पादः न संभवति सो दैट काइंड ऑफ अ कार्य विच इज कारण समुदाय अधीन The karya is coming together of the karana. So that karana coming together, based on which the karya is possible. Karya utpatti is, karya utpada is karya utpatti. Karya utpatti or karya utpada which is adhina, dependent on what? Karana samudaya. Karanas coming together. Karanas have to come together. And that karana samudaya adhina as well as what? Hetu adhina. Hetu should also be there. On which there is a karya which is dependent and the all the hetus which are or the set of these karanas coming together will also be hetu so the hetu is one on which karya utpatti is dependent and the other is what karana samudaya all these coming together and forming the karya that coming together is questionable why because that is what is meant by you When you say karya utpatti, you say not only hetus are there, but karana samudhaya adhina also. Hetu adhina, karana samudhaya adhina. Both are not possible because one will trigger the other and that's all. There is nothing more than that. Just because there is a triggering of the other, you cannot assume that there will also grouping together. That grouping together is not possible of the karanas and therefore samudhaya aprapti stands, tadaprapti. समुदाय प्राप्ति इज स्टिल वैलिड ऑब्जेक्शन फ्रॉम दी सिद्धांत साइड टू दी बौद्ध पक्ष सो दैट इज दी विच इज तथा हेत्वादीन कारण समुदाय दिनश्च कार्योत्पाद न संभवती समुहंतु स्थिरस्य चेतनस्य अनंगीकारात् इत्यर्थः So why so? Because for grouping together, you will still need chetana. So if let's say you know light a matchstick, or the something happens and the fire is lit, that fire may trigger something else. So utpatti of something else. But then lot of things which happen after that are just triggering with the fire. That is possible. But then. Grouping together and doing something is not possible. So, for example, you know, just you know, as a common but a on a tangent kind of an example also, because I talked about fire. Let's say there was a set of wooden pieces kept together, and you wanted to use that to cook. You know, old era kind of a village situation where. Or you're on a picnic or something like that camping. So assume a camping trip outside where you have not carried your there's no gas stove or anything available. You are going to put some wooden pieces together, you know wood, and you stock them. You'll say that okay for these 3 days camps this will be sufficient. And let's say there is some fire elsewhere. That fire somehow triggers the wooden pieces also. Get set on fire. So that kind of a trigger is meant here. So utpatti nimittatvat can be taken as that. So one can lead that something, some friction or something has led to the fire. Now even if that friction, which is one of the skandhas, let's say, that has triggered the fire of that wood which you would otherwise use for cooking. still the paka will not be done. There will be no cooking possible. Samudaya, all that grouping together to form the, you know, to go under the, somehow go under the vessel that you are cooking, and then whatever is in the vessel that to be cooked, all that is not going to happen on its own. Still there is chetana needed to do all that. Just because the wood is set on fire, the cooking, the meal will not be ready. So with a crude example like that, we can try and understand this as to all this trouble is because, you know, we don't really, we didn't go into details of what these rupa, vijnana, ityadi are. So, you know, these rupa, vijnana, vedana, sanya, samskara, what all these include, I'll just mention anyway, because avidyadi are talked about. So how they are categorized under, I'll just mention this. Rupa, I said that rupa is basically the forms. So these, not only sharira, but indriya also, the indriya, vishya, all these are categorized under rupa. Vijnana, under these, vijnana is a pravaha, there is a flow of vijnana. So there, whether alaya, pravruttihi, so ashraya, ityadi, aham. So when you say aham iti, idam iti, all that is vijnana. So which I mentioned as, you know, kshanika vijnana, when you move to kshanika vijnana vadis. But then with that kshanika vijnana vadis explanation of vijnana, we understand what vijnana means for all the four categories of Bauddhas. So vijnana is, although I said that I don't want to go into this, what happens is that without these, the vritti is a little tricky to understand. That's why I try to give an example, but I anyway, let me just give a little bit information of what these are. So vijnana is like what we say as aham vritti, idam vritti. So that is similar to similar for the Bauddhas also, but they say that itself is consciousness. Aham vritti, idam vritti, both are consciousness, they are called as vijnana there, but we call them as vrittis in the antakarana. So they confuse the antakarana vritti itself as vijnana. Vedana is sukha dukha. So vedana means pain really, because in the Bauddha paksha sarvam dukkham, they say sarvam dukkham. Therefore vedana is, you know we say shiro vedana, headache is shiro vedana. So vedana generally is sensation for them. Any sensation is called as vedana there. So although all of that is categorized as dukkha for from the Bauddha darshana's perspective, vedana, that's why perhaps they have called this as vedana. But sukha dukkhadi, all these are sukhadi, are sukha is also part of vedana. Then sanya, although it is a name, but it's a perception. When you say sanya, that name, Vedanti say also, nama and namni, there is no real bheda. Nama is mithya, and namni is, the nama is for the sake of transaction with the namni. Therefore sanya, it is categorized, it is called as perception because it is actually a name. Sanya is a name. Gauhu, ashwaha, ghata, ityadi. When you say gauhu, then the nama gauhu, sanya gauhu, is having nitya sambandha with gopadartha as per the purva mimamsaka, which the uttar mimamsaka agrees with. So similarly here sanya, gauhu, ityadi are just names, but then they are ones which will, based on the whether it is the which kind of Bauddha, based on that this will have meaning as to Vaibhashika and Sautrantika. They say these are the names, but they are just not names. There is padartha, go padartha is there outside. Therefore that sanya is a perception of that gau also. Therefore this sanya means that the perception, it generally means perception. Then samskara is what samskara is which a due to which you identify the gau later. You have seen the gau, you understand what is gau. It has this gau shabda is the gau outside which has left a samskara in your own antakarana. This is how even the Siddhanti will explain. So then this samskara of gau will be there. Next time you see a gau, then that time you will understand that it is gau because there is a samskara. So similarly ghatapata adi jnana, ghatapata adi go ashwadi jnana is what this samskara is. So it's a nama vishishta savikalpa pratyaya, that is samskara, which is there as a in a storehouse which will help understand later. So with this, if you look at the vritti of the next sutra as to avidyajnam itaretara karanatvyapi, even if any of these are karana for each other in a series also, utpatti matra nimittatvat, since they will just lead to the utpatti of the other karana, that karana can become karana for yet another karana, but then there cannot be any grouping or aggregation of these karanas. So karana samudaya adhina tava abhimata karyotpadaha, which is hetva adhina also, na sambhavati. Samhantu, why? Samhantu stirasya chetanasya anangikarat ityartha. Since you do not accept any chetana, nothing other than nimitta is possible, but then even if there is a trigger available, there will be no grouping together of these karanas, and therefore samudaya aprapti, and thereby no karya utpatti is going to be possible. Sarvakshanikatva vadinam hetva dhina api karyotpadaha na sambhavati tyaha. Then this kind of a refutation which has been used for the vaibhashika sautrantika is extended to the sarvakshanikatva vadi, sarvam shunyam also, and those who say that vijnana is shanika. So for them also hetva adhina api karyotpadha na sambhavati tyah. Their karyotpada is also hetva adhina. Without hetu being the basis, there cannot be any karya, meaning hetu mat karya cannot be there. There the Siddhanti says this in the sutra, uttarotpadecha purva nirodhat, uttarotpadecha purva nirodhat. Just let me cross check this vritti, meaning the sangati there, as to there is a typo. Let me check whether there is a typo there. That's for the next sutra. Okay, just a minute. Sarvakshanikatvadinam hetvadinam api karyotpadaha na sambhavati. Okay, so the anvaya is a little tricky there. So hetvadhinaha is what has been agreed with earlier also. So there is no typo there. So tava abhimataha hetvadhina. So you have to contrast this tava abhimata versus the sarvakshanikatva vadinam. So that is a contrast. So this hetu adhinattvam is there in the vaibhashika sautrantika paksha also, and in the kshanika vijnanavadi and sarvashunyavadi paksha also, because hetu should be there. Some hetu should be there. Now this tava abhimata versus the sarvakshanikatva vadi abhimata, that is what the sarvakshanikatva vadinam hetu adhinaha api karyatpadha na sambhavati means there. So what has been said api, by api is saying that not only this tava abhimata, meaning the earlier two bauddha paksha abhimata hetvadhina karyotpada is not possible, but even the other two pakshas hetvadhina karyotpada is not possible, the other two being kshanikavadis and shunyavadis. But then sarvakshanikatva vadi, we'll just take the third one, not shunyavadi yet. Because shunyavadi, when he says shunya is the hetu, then shunya is nothing. Then how can it be a hetu? So there itself there will be a dosha, meaning they saying that shunya is a hetu, shunya is lack of everything. That lack of everything or absence of everything or absence of anything cannot be really a hetu. How can you call it as a hetu? So that kind of a question will come up. Therefore, we'll just consider not as sarva shunyavadi, but sarva kshanikatva vadi. Only the third Buddha who says that vijnana is shanika, and that's all there is nothing else. So sarvakshanikatva vadinam hetva adhina api karyotpadaha na sambhavati tyaha. So there is karya which will be utpanna based on a hetu. Therefore hetu adhina is the karya utpatti or karya utpadaha. That hetu is kshanika vijnana, for the kshanika vijnana vadi. So sarva kshanikatva vadinam hetu, that is the hetu, which is different from the earlier two bauddha pakshas hetus. So that hetu adhina karyotpada is also not possible. Why? Uttarotpade cha purva nirodhat, उत्तरोत्पादे च पूर्व निरोधात. सो उत्तरोत्पादे च पूर्व निरोधात देर इज नो पदच्छेद नीडेड. इट इज ऑलरेडी इन दी देर इज नो समस्त पद देर देर इज नो संधि ऑल्सो. सो देर इज नो संधि नॉट समस्त पद देर इज नो संधि. सो उत्तर उत्पादे when we mentioned that we agree with the utpatti nimittattvam of the earlier meaning in the earlier sutra we said utpatti matra nimittattvat the itaretara pratyayas karanas can be triggers for each other meaning they can lead to utpatti of the others that's all they can do now in the kshanika vijnana paksha we are saying that this uttarutpatti That takes place. Uttarutpada means uttarutpatti. So here uttarutpatti. Utpatti matra nimittatva. So utpatti matra of what? Utpatti of the uttara. Whatever is the next. Whatever that is. Whether it is one leading to the other in a series of the same species. Meaning same class. Or whether of a different class. So one leads to another of the same class or another class. We don't care whatever is there. Darshana. In either case there will be an issue. So if you say it is of the same class also there will be no grouping. If it is of another class also there is no grouping. So Uttara can be of the same class or of the other class. Uttara is latter one. So the latter has an Utpatti. Instead of Utpatti, Utpada word has been used. Has the same meaning. So Uttara Utpade cha. Uttara Utpade Sati cha. Sati Saptami. Even if there is rise of the latter is born. Even if the latter is born, what will happen? Uttarutpade cha. When it is born on Purva Nirodha, the earlier will go away. There will be Nirodha of the earlier. So the next one comes up, the earlier one will not be there. Then, so, you know, let's say, we'll say Karya, not Karya really, but Hetu. Karana only. Let's say Hetu. So one hetu lead to hetu one leads to hetu two, hetu leads to hetu three, and such a series is there. Whether they are of the same class or a different class, we don't care. So when the first one goes away, the second one is born, the first one goes away. So when the hetu two utpada is there, uttara hetu utpada is there, then what will happen? The purva will go away. The earlier will no longer be there. Therefore, what will happen? At the karya being created, when the latter, so we'll say one hetu is the cause for the second hetu, then there will be karya karana bhava sambandha between them. So I'll use the proper word as karana and karya, let's say. So uttara utpade is karya utpade. We are not saying prapancha as a karya, we are just hypothetically saying that one hetu is leading to the other hetu. So the second hetu is a karya. So karya hetu utpad uttara utpada, that is uttara karya hetu utpade sati cha, what will happen? Purva hetu, which is what? Karana. Karana si nirodhat. So karya utpade or karya hetu utpade cha karana hetu nirodhat. We can understand in that manner. That is the sutra artha. And what does that mean? That means therefore hetvadhinaha karya utpada sarvakshanikatvadinam हेत्वादिना अपि कार्य उत्पाद कार्यस्य उत्पाद न संभवति बिकॉज दि कारण इज गॉन व्हेन एट दि टाइम ऑफ कार्य उत्पत्ति इटसेल्फ दि कारण इज गॉन दिस उत्तर उत्पादे इंस्टेड ऑफ सती सप्तमी इट इज बेटर सेइंग दैट इट इज ओनली यू नो काल सप्तमी वी कैन से काल सप्तमी ऑल्सो दैट विल गिव अ बेटर मीनिंग Let me just cross check if that is possible. Just give me a moment. Because Sati Saptami is not working well. It can, but then with the Tarkika's, these Kshanas of the when the Utpatti is all that argument comes to mind. It is used elsewhere in the Bhashya. Just give me a moment whether it will work. Sati Saptami. Sati Saptami won't be good here, so I'll just make a correction. Uttarotpade kale, you can, Kala Saptami you can use, that will be better. So, Uttarotpade kale cha. meaning that's why I'm saying karya karana, to use that there is some issue there, because as per the purva pakshi there is karya, so karya hetu, and there is a karana hetu, so uttarotpada is karya hetu, so we can say that, but then instead of sati we'll say kala saptami. So kala saptami is at the time of, during. So when we say that uttarotpadecha purva nirodhat, what it means is that uttara hetu, which is that karya. So karya uttara karya hetu utpadecha purva karana hetu nirodhat. And what does it mean? Uttara karya hetu utpade samaye kale cha purva karana hetu nirodhat. The karana hetu itself won't be there at the time of utpatti of the next karya, the karya. The first hetu, which is leading to the second hetu, thereby first hetu is karana and second hetu is karya, or we'll just say karana and karya. The karana being hetu for karya is going to be possible only if the karana is there during the time the karya is created. And this is differentiated from the earlier case. In the earlier case, there is no kshanika vijnana. But in the case of sarva kshanikatva vadi, they say that everything is momentary. They say everything is momentary. So your karana is momentary. The hetu 1, hetu 2, hetu 3 all will be momentary hetus. Because everything is momentary, your hetu is also momentary. If hetu is momentary, kshanika, then at the karya utpatti samaya, at that moment your hetu won't be available. Karana will not be available. So when you say hetu 2 has come up due to hetu 1, the hetu 2 production time, hetu 1 will not be there. Because hetu 2 is created in the T2 time, that T2 moment should have T1 moments hetu 1. Hetu 1, which was present at time T1, H1, let's say Hetu 1 is H1. H1 was present at time T1. And it led to H2 at time T2. Hetu 2 at time T2. So the H2 at T2 should have H1 available. But H1 is Kshanika. It is available only at T1. Therefore, at T2, H1 itself will not be available. Then how will H2 come up? Therefore, there is no karya karana sambandha. Although the words we are saying that the uttara karya hetu utpades kale samaye cha purva karana hetu nirodhat, basically there is no karya karana at all. Therefore, uttara utpade purva nirodhat is sufficient enough. There is no karya karana bhava at all. Although you are saying it is not possible. Why? Because karya utpatti, at the time of karya utpatti, karana itself is not there. How will there be utpatti? Why? Kshanikatvat hetoho. So karya kale, so that's the kala saptami. So the sati saptami was not right. Karya kale vidyamanasya eva mrudadehe karanatvam drishyate. So at the time of karya kala mean at the time of production of the karya, vidyamanasya mrudadehe, the clay, so karya kale kasya ghatasya. So ghata karya kale, you can say ghata karya kale, when the ghata is made, then what happens? Ghataadi karya kale, when the ghata ityadi are made, pot etc. are made, then what happens? Vidyamanasya mrudade, the mrudadi, clay etc. which are existent at that point of time, at the time of the creation of the ghata ityadi, teshameva or tasyeva karanatvam drishyate. Only that can be a karana which is existing at the time of creation of the pot. That kind of a clay, etc. is karana. Natu nashtasya. But can the nashta clay, meaning the clay which is no longer there, can that be karana for ghata? It cannot be. So natu nashtasya karanatvam drishyate. Nashtasya mrudadehe karanatvam na drishyate. Bhavan mate tu uttarasya karakshanasya utpade purvasya utpade kale. So at the time when Bhavan Mate Indi Kshanika Vidyanavadis Mata Uttarasya Karakshane Kshanasya, the Karakshana, at the point of time when Ghata is to be created or Ghata comes up, that time Purvasya Karakshanasya Nirodha, the Kshana is gone. The moment the T2 has come up, which is Karakshana, then the karana kshana t1 is gone. And if the car, the moment is gone, the moment has changed, meaning if the moment is gone, then your karana had that, meaning karana time, t1 had karana, that karana nasha has also taken place. Therefore, what? Bhavan mate tu uttarasya karyakshanasya utpade purvasya karanakshanasya nirodhat vinasha angikara dityartha. So both ways, uttarotpade kale cha purva nirodhat, purva kalasya nirodhat, and therefore what? Kshanikatvena uttarotpade mrudadehe karanasya cha nirodhat, meaning the at the ghata creation time, the mrut time is over, meaning the mrut is no longer there when the ghata has to be created. So due to kshanikatva of the time is anyway momentary, but your karana and karya also have this momentary limitation. So karya won't come up if the karana is not available at that point of time. That is the artha. So here what is being said is that कारण क्षणस्य निरोधात विनाश विनाश अंगीकारात इट इज एक्सेप्टेबल टू अस आल्सो दैट द मोमेंट हैज पास्ड बाय बट द मोमेंट इज अ भ्रांति इन अवर केस इन योर केस द मोमेंट हैज पास्ड अवे एंड द दैट मृत हैज आल्सो गॉन दैट मृत कैन नॉट बी कारण एनी मोर सो विच मृत इज कारण द क्ले विच इज कारण फॉर घटा विच विच क्ले विल बी कारण देर इज नो क्ले अवेलेबल द अर्लियर क्ले इज नॉट अवेलेबल The new clay, if you say this clay is karana, this clay cannot be karana for this ghata. Because both have to be available simultaneously. They cannot be available simultaneously in the same moment. Karya and karana cannot be available in the same moment. And if you say that, because there has to be some creation activity. Momentary availability of the karana will make no karya possible. That is the idea. I hope it is clear. The vritti is very short. But then the words are a little tricky. So with the Kala Saptami it will work as to the only the time is mentioned, but with the time you have to take the material also not being available in the time of Karya, when the Karya is being created. So we'll stop here. We'll continue in the next part with the next sutra. Amnayanti samsiddham adi madhyant varjitam anandaghanam apurnam atma jyoti rupasvahe. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Namaste.